this is a momentous day because Donald Trump just bragged on Truth Social yesterday about winning a golf championship at his own club. He wrote, "It is my great honor to be at Trump International Golf Club in West Palm Beach tonight, awards night, to receive the club championship trophy and the senior club championship trophy. I won both. A large and golfing talented membership, a great and difficult course made the play very exciting. The qualifying and match play was amazing. A large and distinguished group will be there tonight. Very exciting. Thank you." This sent shockwaves across the sports world. And Biden thought it was pretty funny too. He wrote, "Congratulations, Donald. Quite the accomplishment." Trump is well known, as many of you know, for cheating at golf. Sports writer Rick Riley wrote in his book, Commander and Cheat, How Golf Explains Trump. Trump doesn't just cheat at golf. He throws it, boots it, and moves it. He lies about his lies. He fudges and foozles and fluffs. At Winged Foot, where Trump is a member, the caddies got so used to seeing him kick his ball down, onto the fairway, they came up with a nickname for him, Pele. To say Donald Trump cheats is like saying Michael Phelps swims. He cheats at the highest level. He cheats when people are watching, and he cheats when they aren't. He cheats whether you like it or not. He cheats because that's how he plays golf. If you're playing golf with him, he's going to cheat. And funny enough, last year, Trump also claimed he beat renowned golf pro Phil Mickelson's score at Bedminster, which, okay, prove him wrong, Cenk, prove him wrong.
A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do. You know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us. Well, first of all, I just want to announce that I'm kind of humbled by this, but I've just gotten voted best in studio host at TYT today. I'm sorry, guys, but I tabulated the vote and it's me. Who says that they won tournaments at their own golf club? I mean, come on, guys. This guy's both, and I'll say to the right and the left. Right, you know he's lying, right? Come on, please, brother, don't make me lose hope and faith in you, please. Not that I have much, but whatever shred I have left, you know he's lying, right? And to the left, please acknowledge the guy's hilarious. Okay, I wish he wasn't a threat to all of us, but he is unintentionally hilarious. So in terms of the cheating, this was written about well before he ever got into politics, because you know he does every interview, which, by the way, in politics, by the way, is a good idea. He's a magnet for, he loves the attention, he loves the spotlight. So, but he can't help himself, right? So he did an interview with a golf reporter at one of his clubs. I forget if it was the 1990s, but way before he got into politics, and he would cheat right in front of the reporter. And the reporter's like, "I'm right here." He'd take it, like he'd hit it into the woods, he'd take it, find it, and throw it, right? He'd kick it all the time. And then he'd say, like, he'd be on the edge of the green, he'd be like, "Yeah, that's an easy putt, I'll pick that one up." He's a hilarious cheater, right? And the person who wrote that book is definitely right. That is telling. I usually can tell a lot about a person by playing basketball with them, right? Are they aggressive, not aggressive? Do they cheat, do they not cheat? You know, how do they handle teammates, etc. And a guy like Trump, who cannot help himself and will cheat right in front of a golf reporter, right? He's addicted, he loves cheating, he can't stop cheating. Did he do that at the White House? Of course he did. Like, no, he doesn't care about any foreign money that might come to him or his family after he leaves office. Wouldn't care about that at all. Wink, right? And every single thing he said and did, he's the world's fittest, the fittest president that's ever been. He self-reported his weight when he at Fulton County, when they, you know, had him do the mugshot, etc. They let him self-report the weight. He said 215 pounds. Come on, come on, come on. I mean, you minimum 50 pounds over that, bare minimum 50 pounds over at 215. He was like, He fabricated at the White House and I think said 255. Where'd the extra 40 pounds go? You look the same, if not worse. Like, he's a hilarious liar. Guys, come on, MAGA. Come on. Don't clown yourself. You gotta at least admit, yeah, the guy's obviously a gigantic liar, right? That's my sense of it, Jordan.
This is one of my favorite Trump stories in a while, not just because it's so outrageous and the lie is just so blatant. It's that this was happening the day before he was expected to post bond. Like, you have this huge legal issue hanging over your head and your lawyers are saying you can't pay these bills. You could start losing your assets. You need to be scrambling to find this money. And what is he focused on? I won two trophies today. I won two trophies at golf and I'm the best and nobody beat me at my own course. That I think is really, really good. And I know a lot of people are gonna, like, anytime the Biden campaign tries to do something fun or different or interesting or creative on social, everyone kind of rolls their eyes. I did think the response was really funny from that team. Just congrats, that's a major accomplishment. Just totally sarcastic, way to go, man. Focus on the important things. I love this story.
Yeah, and totally agree. Last fun fact for you guys. Obama spent way too much golfing when he was president. And I criticized him about that at the time. Like, bounds of reason. Let's get to work here. He did 98 rounds of golf while he was president for 8 years. Trump in 4 years, 266 days golfing. That's almost a whole year. It's okay, fine. It's a 99 days off of a full year. That is a stunning number of vacations to take. Days of vacation in just 4 years. Do you guys get to take 266 days off in 4 years? And that doesn't include his vacations. That was just his golfing. He doesn't give a rat's ass about you. All he cares about is how rich am I gonna be, how much can I golf, and how much can I lie about how well I golf. He beat Phil Mickelson. Come on, guys. Yeah, I know, and I beat Tom Brady the other day. I guess MAGA will believe anything. And Michael.
It wasn't just that he beat Phil Mickelson. It was that he beat Phil Mickelson by 8 strokes, which is just crazy.
Yeah, I know. I know. And LeBron couldn't get a point off me.
Yeah.
As long as we're doing Kim Jong-un type lies.
Right. And we're into that territory. Yeah. It is really impressive.
Next, he'll claim that he has no anus. That was Kim Jong-un's dad who claimed that. So, this close. If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.